There are two ways to find the position of a straight line with respect to a circle. Today we will find it using the discriminant. To find the position of the straight line, we need to find out whether the line intersects the circle at two points or at one point or no point at all. If it is intersecting at two points, then the line is inside the circle. If it is intersecting at one point, then the line is on the circumference of the circle. And if it is not intersecting the circle at all, then the line is outside the circle. So let's take a general circle x squared plus y squared plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equals 0. And a line y equals mx plus c1, where m is the gradient of this straight line. So the first step we do is substitute y from this equation into this equation. So that will be x squared plus y squared. So instead of y, we write mx plus c1. So that will be mx plus c1 squared plus 2gx plus 2f into y. So that is 2f into mx plus c1 plus c equals 0. When we open the brackets, we can arrange it as 1 plus m squared into x squared plus 2 into mc1 plus g plus fm into x plus c1 squared plus 2fc1 plus c equals 0. So now this is in the form ax squared plus bx plus c equals 0. In a quadratic equation, we have something called the discriminant. So the discriminant delta x equals b squared minus 4ac. This discriminant is used to tell whether we have two values for x or one value for x or no value for x. When delta x is greater than 0, we have two values for x, which means that the line intersects the circle at two points and the line lies inside the circle. When delta x equals 0, there is only one value for x and the line touches the circle only once and it lies on the circumference of the circle. When delta x is less than 0, there is no value for x and the line does not touch the circle at all and it lies outside the circle. So by using the discriminant, we can tell the position of the line with respect to a circle. Let's try out an example to understand this better. So here we have to find the position of the line 3x plus 4y plus 21 equals 0 with respect to the circle x squared plus y squared minus 4x plus 6y plus 4 equals 0. So first, we subject y in the equation of the straight line. So y equals minus 21 minus 3x divided by 4. So then we substitute this y into this equation of the circle. So that is x squared plus minus 21 minus 3x over 4 whole thing squared minus 4x plus 6 into minus 21 minus 3x over 4 plus 4 equals 0. So when we simplify all of this, we get 25x squared minus 10x plus 1 equals 0. So now it is in the form ax squared plus bx plus c equals 0. So here the discriminant delta x equals b squared minus 4ac. So here b is equal to minus 10 and a is equal to 25 and c is equal to 1. So delta x equals 10 squared minus 4 into 25 into 1. So that is equal to 100 minus 100. So that gives us 0. Since delta x equals 0, we have only one value for x. So the line will touch the circle only once, which means that the line 3x plus 4y plus 21 equals 0 lies on the circumference of this circle x squared plus y squared minus 4x plus 6y plus 4 equals 0. So that's how you find the position of the line using the determinant. Now for the tip of the day. For those of you who are wondering where we got this delta x, we take a look at the quadratic formula, that is x equals minus b plus or minus b squared minus 4ac whole thing square root over 2a. So we use this formula to find the values of x in a quadratic equation. So the part under the square root here is the discriminant. Based on this value, we can find the number of values of x in a quadratic equation. So that's all for today's video. Comment down below if you have any questions regarding this topic. Until we meet again, take care.